welcome back to my channel. I just want to start off by saying sorry to you guys for the random inconsistency. So my last video with the Stormy collection, it did really good. It's doing great. Every time I check, every day there's more and more views. I'm almost at 800 views on that video, and I just want to say thank you to you guys because you guys did your thing on that. But I actually tried recording a video like a week after I posted that one, so like I would keep up with my consistency because I was posting videos every single week. And this whole thing happened. I couldn't save the video. It was just a mess. And if you have me on Twitter and Instagram, which is where you guys usually get my videos, like the link to my videos, you guys saw what had happened. I don't really feel like explaining it, but it was just a mess and it was really unfortunate, and I kind of like lost all hope. I'm kind of dramatic, but it was annoying because that was my first time posting a video, like doing my whole face for you guys and doing a whole makeup look for you guys. But that's okay, that's what we're here for today. So first off, I also want to apologize if my audio, like the quality of the audio, is not up to par like the way I usually sound. It's because I'm not wearing my mic today, but that's because I'm charging my phone as I record. And yeah, I have to plug in my mic, and I don't have to, you know what I mean, whatever, I can't. So so I'm gonna hop right in with you guys. I'm gonna be doing a look today. I'm trying to achieve this look right here. I'm gonna put it right there, and we're gonna see how this comes out. I'm using this palette. I just got it today, not that long ago. It's the 351 Icy Fantasy Morphe palette, and I got it for $25 in Ulta. And yeah, I decided I wanted to do a look for you guys. How pretty is she? She's a queen. She's beautiful. And yeah, this is what we're using today. And I actually did my eyebrows off camera, and so it's gonna be easy. I'm gonna hop right in to the eyes for you guys. And yeah, before I hop right in, you guys like, comment, share, subscribe, and yeah, keep watching if you want to see me achieve this look. I'm gonna start off by priming my eyes with concealer. I'm using the Born This Way concealer. Okay, I'm gonna blend that out. Of course, I'm using my James Charles palette for my mirror, but we're not using her today. Sorry, Jamesy. Where the hell is my beauty blender? We're just gonna blend out the concealer. How do you guys usually do? Do you guys do eyes first and then your face, or you do your face than your eyes? I don't know how people do face and eyes. Like, what the heck, you have fallout. I don't know. More power to you though if you do. Okay, there you go. We're all primed. Now that I look like a ghost, let's hop right in to this palette. Woo! I wish this one had a mirror. But all right, yeah, we're just gonna hop right in with the blue shade. It's called Into the Blue, and I'm gonna use it right next to me, the one thing with the names. So it's called Into the Blue, and we're gonna use, which brush are we gonna use? I'm gonna use this brush. Okay, and hop right into this. Okay. Woo! I'm excited. Okay, guys. So for this part, I decided that I'm gonna do a little voiceover. So you guys just don't have to sit there watching me apply the eyeshadow. So basically, in this part, what I decided to do was just pat in and pack the blue onto my like brow bone-ish area, and that's because after this step, I am going to blend it out with the white eyeshadow. And I just feel like doing this step like this by just packing on top of the brow bone, it allowed me to build it up a lot more easier.
And yeah, that's basically what I'm doing in this step.
I'm gonna go in with the shade White Out, that very white first white shade, with this same brush, and I'm gonna blend it out.
Okay guys, like I told you in step one, I decided to blend out the blue shade with just a plain white shade, and I'm using the same exact brush I was using.
So now I'm going to cut my crease with the concealer. I really wish this palette had a mirror because I'm over here working with two palettes and it's annoying. I'm gonna use this brush. She's ugly, but that's okay.
Okay guys, so for step three, we're cutting our crease. So basically all I'm gonna say in this step, for like a little tip on how to cut your crease, is you place a bit of it of the concealer onto your eyelid, and if you look up, I don't know if you saw me do it because this is like a sped up, but if you saw me do it, yeah, I looked up and it leaves the concealer exactly where you should cut the crease. So yeah.
Okay, I don't really like what I did there by accident, but that's okay. So now, see to the other side. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cover my eyelid with white. Yeah, cover my eyelid with white. I don't know what brush to use to pack it on. Let's see. We'll use this.
Alright guys, so very simple, step four. All you're gonna do is take a brush to pack on the white onto the cut crease, and right on top of the concealer while it's wet, so it could stick right on, and it gives us that perfect base so that we can apply our glitter afterwards.
Ooh, okay, cute, I like. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take, I think I know what I'm, okay, I'm gonna wet my brush that I'm gonna use to put the glitter on. There you go, I wet it a little. And then we're gonna take my glitter. I'm nervous, this glitter makes me nervous because it's so loose and it could be so messy. I'm just gonna hold it in my hand while I do it and dip right in. Oh my god, which side is wet? Dip right in. Oh, it's holding a lot. And then just apply that right on top. Ooh. Apply that on top. I don't know if it's gonna stick.
Okay guys, so step five, we're just applying the loose glitter right on top of the white eyeshadow. And actually what I ended up doing after this part is I wet my actual eyelid. I sprayed rose water, and that's what made the glitter stick really well.
So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back in with the blue and start like blending the crease. So let me get my blue.
Alrighty, so this step is pretty simple. We're just going back in with the blue and blending our crease a little bit just so it won't look super harsh. Very simple step, and I'm doing it to both eyes. And like I said, it's just so it could blend all together and come all together and look whole. So yeah.
Now I'm gonna do a wing liner using my e.l.f. liquid liner.
Okay guys, so I did film me doing my wing liner, but I'm gonna cut it out of this video because I did end up having a little temper tantrum, and I got pretty annoyed with it because it came out a lot thicker than what I usually do it, but it ended up working out. So yeah,
so now I'm just gonna put my lashes on. I use Kiss lashes. I use them in the style Flirty. These, I've used them previously. These are it. Alrighty. And I use the Let me find my lash glue. Okay. I use the Kiss Strip Lash adhesive with aloe in clear. So yeah, we're just gonna apply those. Don't really know which eye they belong on, but we're just gonna go in. And then you wanna let them get tacky, so I let them sit there for a little bit. And while they sit there, I put on a mascara. You already know which mascara I'm using, my fave, if I can find it. Why can't I find it? This is absolutely bonkers. I can't. Okay, I found it. My Thrive Cosmetics mascara.
Very simple, very easy. Everyone knows how to apply mascara. Just don't get it on your eyeshadow. Very simple. My eyelashes were kind of crispy because I had got the liquid eyeliner on them, but that's okay.
Okay. I feel like I'm gonna like this a lot better once I put the lashes on and I do my, like, the rest of my face. Because right now, I don't know how I feel. But that's usually how it goes for me. Okay, so I'm gonna put the first one on.
So I'm gonna try my best to explain to you guys the way I put my lashes on. Of course, I use tweezers, and what I do, of course, after, once my lash gets tacky from the glue, I take my mirror and I put it below my face. I don't put it directly in front of my eyes. I put it below, and it's a lot more easier for me to see where I'm applying the lash. And you want to start by putting it in the center and then securing it on each end. And of course, you want to make sure you trim your lashes from the inner corner. These were already pre-trimmed because I had used them previously before this video. And yeah, that really helps with not having your inner lash lift up.
Wonder why it was so easy. But anyways, now we're going to hop into the face. But before I do that, let me wipe off. Okay, this is dry. Let me get a different face wipe. Wipe off any fallout from, like, the glitter, because that glitter was a mess. Okay. There. And the foundation we're going to be using today is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 foundation. Whew, I'm ready. Oh, you guys like my sweater? Just peachy. Okay. And I use a pump and a half of this. I kind of basically did 2 pumps, but whatever. And yeah.
So, to be honest with you guys, I don't really have a specific way of applying my foundation onto my face. And for starters, I just want to say that my foundation, it might appear a bit darker. For some reason, in the light, it looks pretty, it looks like it matches pretty well. But in regular lighting, it kind of, it's kind of a little darker than my face. But let me get back to, like, what I was saying. I don't apply it a certain way. You just want to make sure you blend to your neck, as I did. And you want to get it all over your face. You make sure you get the perfect coverage in every spot. You don't want to have more coverage in a certain spot than the other. You're going to look patchy, and you don't want that. And you want to get as close to your hairline like I'm doing right now. And I didn't want to get it in my hair, which is, but I usually pull my hair back. I just was being lazy. And yeah, that's really it.
Remember, keep in mind, I like to wipe off anything that I put on the back of my hand, because I have a bad habit of getting makeup on my clothes and it stains, so don't want that. Again, I'm using the Born This Way concealer. I'll go right in.
As for concealer, guys, I like to get as close to the under eye as possible because I love to hide my bags, because they are not Chanel, they are not Gucci, they're not it. So I love to cover them because you just want to look flawless, you want to look covered. And another tip that I can say for concealer is you want to just keep everything in the same place. Don't try and move it around too much. Blot it all into the same place. And yeah, that's basically it for concealer. Very simple, just to highlight certain points.
The Fit Me pressed powder in the shade 120 Classic Ivory, but like I was looking for the translucent one. They had ran out that day. Oh my god. There you go, I cut it off. That was so annoying. Make sure you're creasing this. I do this before my bronzer, my contour, because I crease like a old person. It's annoying. It's okay, it looks kind of crazy right now, but then you brush it off, so. All right, I get around my mouth. I crease like crazy. Oh my god, it looks funny. Okay. And now I take a big powder brush and I just dust it all off. Okay. Now we're gonna contour our face. Well, I'm actually using a bronzer, but whatever. Okay. So the bronzer I'm gonna be using today is the Wet n Wild bronzer. I'm gonna use my contour brush.
So while I do this step, I'm just going to give you guys a few tips for contouring slash bronzing your face. For starters, I just want to say that there definitely is such thing as bronzers that are too dark for your skin tone or too light. You don't want to look orange. You don't want to look like you have a streak of, I don't even know, on the side of your face or on your forehead or nose. And if you're a darker skin tone and you don't have one that complements your skin tone, you're not gonna get the dramatic effect that you want when you bronze up your face. And another thing I can say is work your way up. As you can see, I'm not really trying to bring it down towards my mouth. I keep going in upwards motions and in circular motions as well. And you wanna keep everything in the same place because you don't want to look like you have circles of brown stuff on the sides of your face. And then you also want to get around your forehead. It just shapes your forehead. It makes it look less big like mine. And then you contour your nose. And one tip I can say for contouring your nose, you see I bring it up into my brow bone and it just blends it. It makes it come together a lot better. And if you feel like it's too harsh, you can take a beauty blender and just blend out the parts that you feel like come out a little too harshly for your likings. And that's pretty much it.
Next, we're going to do blush. Blushity blush blush. I'm going to use the Wet n Wild Color Icon blush in the shade Rosé Champagne. And for that, I'm going to be using a flat top brush like this. It's Wet n Wild. Let's get in there. Smile. Show me those cheeks. This is my all-time favorite blush. You see how it's shimmery. There. We're good on blush. Next is, I'm gonna finish up the bottom of my eyes next. So, I'm gonna go with the purple. Where's this brush? Is it the brush I was using? Yep. With this brush, I'm gonna go into the purple shade right there and go into the under eye.
For this step and applying the purple shade on the lower lash line, I suggest using a very skinny brush like the one I'm using. I don't suggest using anything wider or bigger than that because you want to keep it right there. You don't want it to blend out onto like your actual face. You want to keep it right there on that lash line, your waterline, whatever you want to call it.
And last but not least, we're gonna do our favorite part. Hi, Nate. I'm using a fan brush. Oh yes, we love. Wow, this might be one of my favorite looks. Just might be if my eyelash stood in place. That's fine. And lastly, for the lip, I don't know what to do for the lip color. I didn't plan this, but I think I'm just gonna throw on some gloss. Let's see. Everything looks cute with this. I feel like something... I'll do this. I'm gonna use this shade. What is this lip liner? Where's my infamous lip liner? What does this look like? Oh no, this is cute. This works, right? I like that.
As for this step, I'm just gonna give you guys some tips on lining your lips. If you feel like you want to try overlining your lips, what I do suggest is just lining your actual lip line and then working around that. Don't instantly try to give yourself Kylie Jenner lips because you might mess up and you're gonna be upset. And then for the lipstick, very simple. You make sure you don't cover that lip line completely because it's there for a reason. It's there to give definition to the lips.
Okay, I like this. Oh, this is cute. I'm gonna. Stop acting up, eyelash. Oh, I love this. I hope you guys love this look because I love it. I freaking love. And that's that. We're done. I don't want to do setting spray. I'm scared it's gonna mess up my look. As far as bottom mascara for your bottom lashes, I feel like that's really preference. I don't like to do it. I think this looks so cute and clean. My eyelash is acting up. But yeah, so that's today's look, guys. I'm gonna close out today's video. I hope you really enjoyed it. I love this look. It came out so cute. This might be one of my favorite looks that I've ever done. Super icy, super cute. And I absolutely adore this. So be sure to like, comment, share, subscribe. Catch me on your TV screen. Catch me on your laptop screen. Catch me on your phone screen. Catch me on your flip phone. Catch me there because I'm going to be there. All right? Bye, guys. Have a good one. Mwah.